I've been dreaming on in my head like I've seen it. A life worth living is a life with meaning. I'll do what I love till my heart stops beating. I'm feeding this demon. Got a taste, can't erase bitterness in my face. Work a job every day till your dreams fade away. Like a card, never change, play the game that we say.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me today. I really appreciate it. And like always, if you're not a subscriber, please subscribe and please thumbs up my videos. This morning, near Stillmore, Georgia, at 4:05 a.m., there was a magnitude 3.9 earthquake. 1,294 people said they felt this earthquake. As you know, these earthquakes are caused by the Atlantic plate slowly moving, putting pressure against the North American plate. And this is not good. This is what they call an oblique thrust earthquake, where the one side of the fault rises up and it actually fractured. It actually moved, where the other side stayed stationary. It's not good because it indicates that more pressure has built and is waiting to be released. It was reportedly felt over a fairly large area, all the way up north to Greenville, it looks like, and that gave it an intensity level of 5. As you know, earthquakes on the East Coast do seem to travel for a very long distance, but intensity level 5 means it was felt by most people, and they had some breakage, maybe dishes, windows, and cracks in their plaster. Disturbance of tall objects. Maybe they fell over. It was felt as far as North Charleston, or Charleston, intensity level 2. Let's see, we got Savannah, Georgia, or close to there. Richmond Hill, intensity level 5. Soperton, intensity level 5. And down here close to the border with Florida. Well, we got here Camellia, intensity level 3. Brunswick, intensity level 3. Over here, we got another intensity level of 5 from Richmond. Two monitors there in Georgia that I downloaded data from. This one actually is the really good one. Because right here, let me make it bigger, you can see that the tectonic plates were moving, oh, how many hours? About 6 hours before this earthquake, and it rattled for, oh, almost a whole hour. Yeah, and then up over here, there was another slight movement or trying to move right up over here. But this is, yeah, this is intense right here. And let's go up over here and look at that. Well, it's not showing it very well. I think they fudged on the size of the earthquake. I get a magnitude 4.2. Yeah, it was actually that, maybe a little bit stronger. We'll go to its signature. Yeah, it's got a long P wave. And that's because I took it from this earthquake station. Let's see how many miles that is. About 104 miles. Northwest. At 11:42, there was a slow moving, what they call a tremor. And let's bring this over so you can see it. Yeah, a long, quiet earthquake. That's what the spectrogram looked like. At 10:44 and 25 seconds, yeah, another small tremor. At 15:56, yet another tremor, slow-moving quake. But no aftershocks, no earthquakes. Here on the monitor, CMGA, you can see there's some very small earthquakes that were occurring. And this is when I pulled the files right there. Now that earthquake station is right there, CMGA. Here's the other earthquake station. And let me go back over here. There's the earthquake station for that monitor. Here's the earthquake. So that was about 153 miles northwest. Yeah, so there it's picking up as the plate moves. It's just logical as the tension has applied. Yeah, we got some small earthquakes in this location. And let me close this out and close that out. Yeah, we got the National Forest up over here. We got Atlanta, Georgia. Not a lot of historical earthquakes in this location. Again, there's the 3.9. But in 1924, there was a 4.4. What else we got going towards there? See, a lot of fours. There's been a lot of fours in the past. I did see a five somewhere, but I want to go just within this location. Maybe going a little bit northeast to see what the largest ones might have been. See, 1916, a 5.5. In 1874, there was an earthquake swarm. That was Lake Lure. And evidently, they had over 100 mild earthquakes in 1874. So a lot of you felt this earthquake. Most people probably did not report it to USGS. And like I said, it was larger. It was like a 4.2. Yeah, and the energy looks like it was transferred up to South Carolina, close to Atlanta. Yeah. So, did you feel this earthquake? How did your pets react before it? And are they still uneasy and nervous afterwards? Did you have any damage? Because in some of these locations, Cobbtown, Soperton, and there's another one here, Richmond Hill, two people said they had some strong shaking. And what else do we got that might be strong shaking? Let's see. Let's see. Intensity level 4 in Greensboro. McDougal. Sorry for pronouncing it wrong. Now that was intensity level 4. Modoc. Intensity level 4. And Clark's Hill, I believe that is. I got it right on the edge there. And then, yeah, some more intensity level 4s up over here. Blythewood, Greenwood, etc. Got one way over here. Loganville. I want to thank you once again for watching, and thank you very much for subscribing. If you wish to support my work, I'm on Patreon. Many of you have. And they've also donated to me, which I really appreciate it. Thank you very much. And always be prepared for a disaster if you're prepared. Yeah, there's do what you can and leave it up to God, and there's no fear. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you.